Hi, I'm Amber Doig-Thorne, and I do comedy sketches and pranks sometimes, mainly comedy sketches. Like, I've had it a lot where people will email me for a collab, and you can tell it's just a super generic email, and it's literally just like, hey, love your content, want a collab? And I'm like, okay, they've probably sent this to like 500 other creators. So if I'm approaching someone, I always try and say, look, here's the idea that I want to do to you. This is kind of tailored to you, your content, your audience. Here's what I can bring to the table. Here's like the value that I can bring. Obviously, I want to work with you because you're a great content creator. I think you have to make sure that it's like a collaboration is a two-way road and you both have to be bringing something to the table. I always think it's so much easier collabing with friends. Like, I very rarely collabed with strangers, just because it's similar to what you just said. If you don't have the chemistry on screen, I feel like it's quite difficult to fake. And if you've met someone for the first time and you're making a video, people are going to be able to see that you don't really get on. So yeah, it's definitely easier to collab with friends. I think just have a conversation, figure out what you can do that will suit both of your channels. And the fact that you get on already, it's going to be a good video because you have good chemistry.
Right.
So maybe try to get to know people a bit before you ask for a collab is probably my advice. All the collabs I've done, I've been really lucky, they all went really well. Like, I really liked my video and I liked their video, and then I collabed with a friend, so I thought it would be fine. And we did a video for their channel and it was totally cool. And then we did a video for my channel, and it's the type of stuff that I normally do, but it was like a public interview and I don't think they've ever done that before. And the footage was just awful.
What made it awful?
I think it's, so we were kind of taking it in turns interviewing the public, and it is quite a daunting thing to do if you've not done it before. And the footage just wasn't quite, like, they're a really bubbly person, but it didn't really come across on camera, and it was just a bit awkward, and it's kind of the same as what Evan said. Like, there were some weird jokes, and I was like, oh, no, I can't put that in.
It just didn't fit.
Yeah, it just wasn't quite right. So I said I wasn't going to upload the video, but let's do it again, and I just basically got ghosted.
Ooh.
And did they upload theirs?
Yeah. They uploaded theirs, and it was, right. Like, it was a good video. That's why I was like, let's do another one. Like, we get on well, we can make it work, and they just ignored me.
Ooh.
So you also have done Celebrity...
Yeah, so someone from, it wasn't, I don't watch Love Island, so I'm not going to say who it is.
Are they here today? Sorry, but Love Island is still here.
Yeah.
Have you not seen this? So right, I'm so sorry, we'll get onto that in a second. It's just that right now, the XL is populated by YouTubers, Jehovah's Witnesses, and Love Island.
Weird combination.
It's like, it's a classic joke. It's, I don't understand. Anyway, you were approached by people from Love Island this year, or?
No, so it was last year. I think it was like last year in January, and a mutual friend reached out and they were like, oh, one of my friends was on Love Island and they did really well and they wanted to work with you. So they're quite big on Instagram and I'm quite big on Facebook. So they're like, they want to do a video on your Facebook and they'll help you grow your Instagram.
Huh.
So I was like, okay, this sounds really good. So it started off and it was like really well and we started talking and she was really nice. And then she was like, oh, okay, before we collab, can you just do all of this stuff for me? And it was like ridiculous. So she had this app coming out. This might give away who it was. She had this app coming out and she was like, oh, can you just do all of this free promotion and like these dedicated videos? And it like... it wasn't a collab, it just turned into like me doing lots of free work for her. And then when we started talking about doing a collab, I got ghosted again.
Oh my God. Did you feel like it's because they didn't understand you and your work and what this industry is?
Well, I just thought it was weird because she approached me, so I would have thought that she'd know what I...
Did she come directly or was that with
the manager? No, so it was, she talked to a mutual friend. I'm guessing that she must have seen something I was doing on Facebook and thought, oh, it'd be cool to collab.
Right.
I had some really good ideas and I sent over some like comedy sketch ideas and I was like, here's what we can do on your Instagram. Here's what we can do in this Facebook. This is like, we can make it work. And yeah, it was just, it was very one-sided. So I think you need to be careful. If you're reaching out to someone, I kind of feel like you have the power. But if someone's reaching out to you and they're bigger than you, just make sure they don't use you.
And to make sure it's all above board and you've
only worked.
That's very solid advice.
It was like a brand deal and it was doing Urban Dictionary with my dad.
God.
So it was like all of these slang words and my dad is really funny anyway and it's like one of my favorite videos that I've ever done just asking him these terms that we use all the time and he was getting everything so wrong. Like, I'm so glad that he was born when he was and not now because he'd probably have no friends. Like, no one would know what he's talking about.
Also, if he was born now, then you probably wouldn't
be
here.
Yeah, I wouldn't be born.
Like, logistically, that would be.
No, I think, like, collabing with your parents and family members is really good because people are watching your channel because they're interested in you and your personality. And obviously, your family is kind of an extension of that. So even if your parents don't really understand what you do, get them involved because it'll be funny.